Hello guys, in this video I am going to discuss some prerequisites needed for memory interfacing. Okay, so first of all, what is memory? So memory, we can say a system that stores something, okay, and we are talking about the microprocessor, so we can more precisely say a system which can store digital data, okay, because nowadays we require digital data only. Okay, so we can say that finally memory is nothing but that can store digital data is called memory. Now we know that a flip-flop is able to store a digital data, okay, one flip-flop is able to store 1 bit of data, okay, so this is a flip-flop. Now to store multi-bit data we use register, okay, we use what? Register, okay. Now it can be of 4-bit, 8-bit, anything, okay. So let's say this is the register, okay, it can store up to D0, D1, all up to D7, so it can store 8-bit of data, okay. Then so memory consists of what? A register only, but it consists of registers, or we can say it consists of group of registers, okay. So there are so many registers, okay, in a memory in this sequence, okay. So let's say there are m number of registers, okay, and let's say each register is able to store n bit of data in it, okay. It means that there are m number of registers, okay, and each register can store n bit of data, okay, done. So now we can say, we can denote memory as m cross n, where m is what? Number of registers, or now we can say number of memory locations, okay, and n is what? N indicates the size, okay, size of the data, okay, in each location, okay. So general notation of memory is what? M cross N, where M indicates number of locations, okay. So we can say M indicates the address of each of the location, done. So this is the notation of memory, M cross N. Now I am going to discuss a general block diagram, okay, general block diagram. Of a memory, okay. Now before that, let us discuss this with an example. For example, someone says 16 cross 4 memory chip is given. So what does it mean? Here M is 16 and N is what? 4. So we can say that this memory consists of 16 locations and each location is capable to store 4-bit data, okay. I hope it is clear. Now let us discuss about the general block diagram, okay. So let's say this is our memory, M cross N, okay, then so what a memory consists of? A memory consists of address input lines, data input lines and control inputs, okay. I repeat, a memory consists of, first is address, input lines, second is data input lines, okay, and third is control input, okay, inputs, okay. So first we will discuss address inputs, okay. So this is the first one. Now these are address inputs, okay. Let's say there are p number of address input lines, okay, and let's say this is the data inputs. Let's say there are n number of data input lines, okay. So and let's say these are control inputs. Now one thing is to be noted that the address bus is unidirectional while the data bus is bidirectional. It is very much obvious, okay. Now we have one relation. Let me write first everything. First is address inputs, okay. So we have p number of address input lines, and for which purpose this is used? These lines are used for, or we can say these lines are used to specify address of the required memory location, okay. Done. So let me repeat. We have what, p number of address lines, okay. So we know that this m indicates what, the number of locations, okay. So this p lines are used for what? To specify the address, okay. Now there is one relation between m and p. We can say that 2 raised to p equals to m, okay. So if we take example, let's say 16 cross 4, then our m is what? 16. So we can say 2 raised to p equals to 16. It implies p equals to 4. So what we can say, we need 4 address lines to have 16 different combinations . Okay, these are from what, 0000 to 1111, okay. Agree? Now how these lines are used, let's take an example. Let's say we have p equals to 4, that is we have m equals to 16, okay, and let's say we have 16 cross 4 memory, okay, that is each location is capable of storing 4 bit data. Now this is location 0, this is location 1, okay, and so on up to location 15, because we have total 16 locations. In between there will be one location 10 also, okay. Now let's say our address inputs, that is this one, address inputs, that is here address inputs are how many? 4. Let's say our address inputs are 1010. Now it is in binary, In decimal, we can say it is 10 in decimal. Agree? So, if we apply 1010 as the address input to the memory, then we can access what? Its 10th location. Now, according to our need, we can either read data from this location, okay? We can either read or we can either write data to it, okay? So, in this way, we can have 4 number of address inputs to access 16 different number of locations, okay? Now, one thing I wanna say is that over here, okay, there is one decoder, okay, let me write here, there is one decoder. So what we can say, address inputs are given to this decoder, okay, done. So depending on number of binary number adjusted on P number of input lines, okay, the decoder output will select the corresponding memory location and we can access it, okay, done. So simple, you know that a decoder has n inputs and 2^n outputs, okay, these are inputs, okay, done. So here we have 4 inputs, okay, so we have 2^4, that is 16 outputs, okay, and this is only required because we have 16 cross 4 memory, okay. So this is all about address input lines. Now let's say we have second number, what we have, data inputs, okay, these are the data input lines. We have n number of data input lines, this n and this n, both are equal, okay. So now for what purpose they are used, that we will see in next lecture, okay. So thank you so much, see you in the next one.